now, and we are just a few days away from one of the largest displays of art and competition in our region.
Artisphere returns to downtown Greenville this weekend. 7 News' Christine Scarpelli already getting ready now. She's talking about, though, the artistry of the food that's there.
Yes, there is so much artistry in this food, guys, especially as it goes.
And we have one of those times where live television doesn't
These
work, and now
students,
it's back working again.
The students will be competing this weekend, yes, in Artisphere, guys. Sorry about that. But four of them, in fact, four career centers here in Greenville County. So we've got Bonds, Ennery, Donaldson, Golden Strip. We're representing Golden Strip here today.
That's right.
And we have, of course, Chef Archer from Donaldson. And you guys say this is not possible without sponsors, correct?
No. We reached out to a couple of different groups of people, and South Carolina Restaurant and Lodging Association was gracious enough to help pay for our booth entry fee.
That's huge. So that means they made this possible.
They did.
And this is a big deal for the kids, right?
It is. They love it. It's something that after last year they've been looking forward to and talking about all year.
And you mentioned last year. What happened last year, Chef E? That was pretty impressive.
Yes, quite fun indeed. Last year we were actually awarded with the best in show in the Culinary Cafe. So, you know, against the seven other restaurants that we competed against, I think that they chose wisely.
I mean, these are students. You
correct.
Work hard
and the
all
kids
year.
Did, I mean, they put in the work and I feel like we were rewarded for what we put in.
Mm-hmm.
And the elote and taco returning were the show case dishes that got us that award, so I'm glad that it's making an appearance. And along with the SCRLA, Greenville Tech has also generously given us over $1,000 actually to make sure that our fee was paid up. And to work so closely with the Culinary Institute of the Carolinas, actually have kids going straight to that college right after they graduate this program in a matter of weeks. So it's kind of cool.
And that can help for their careers after.
Oh, absolutely. Post-secondary is so important in the culinary field now because of how competitive this business is and how fast it's growing and how trendy it is in Greenville. I feel like it's just a perfect place for a student to become really successful here in the area.
You know, you mentioned that Greenville growing so fast. You hear about that all the time. New restaurants opening up. Well, they have to have staff.
Correct. And, you know, one of the main things we talk about in our advisory committee meetings is how do we place students in the workforce, you know. And I think the main job for us here at Career Centers is to get them ready for the real world and the industry. And doing stuff like Artisphere, although it's fun and it gives them something to do and something to talk about and something to take home, it also gets them ready for the events that Greenville is doing every year. Fall for
That's
Greenville, Artisphere, Euphoria.
Definitely.
And it's just, it's awesome to watch it all kind of to just undergo. It's awesome.
Chef E, you nailed it. Also, you teach them things like what, food safety, handling?
Food safety and sanitation. Mm-hmm. They get certified with that right off the bat so that they're serving safe food to themselves and the public.
Huge.
And then we work our way up through knife skills. My students were able to break down a pig this year. We got a pig donated, so they learned how to take a whole pig, break it down into the individual cuts, and have been able to use it all year.
Huge, huge skills, lots of fun. Artisphere coming up this weekend. Check them out on East Broad. We'll see you soon.
All right. Thanks, Christine.
Yep.
All right. Emily has the day off today. We